set and ready to go. Hello everyone, can anyone hear me? Hello? Right, can you hear me now? Oh, this is a real strain on my knee. Damn it, just give me a moment, just try to sort myself out. Hello?
Hi.
Hi.
Let me guess, internet's herping the derp derp.
What?
Your internet's giving you trouble?
Yes and no. That my knee's acting like hell. Because I tried because I was trying to go downstairs.
Oh dear. That does not sound good.
I'll be alright in a bit. I'm alright going upstairs. It's alright. It's just going down. It's a bit stressful. Well, anyways, let's get started. Now, I was going to do Pokken Tournament, but I can't really get to the disc at the moment. Because if I stand up for too long, it's going to put pressure on the knee. So. We are going to do some old games via the Wii U. Two of them I've only just bought today.
Nice.
You sound a bit off. You seem a little bit off.
Bit what?
You sound a little bit off in terms of voice.
Oh, sorry. My brother and I got into a rather nasty, verbal dispute last night.
Ah. Right.
Yeah, he would not allow me to grab my laptop so I could be ready for in the morning for school. So, yeah. And by the way, dude, if we ever do a Pokemon battle, beware for my Pokemon team. I have a good bond with them. Like, literally, with all the Pokemon on my team, I have max happiness.
As do most of mine. Anyway, we're going to be starting things off with the GBA version of Super Mario Brothers 3.
Cool. Also, quick question, what do you need to do, streams of, Pokemon, games for, the Nintendo DS?
Well, some of the Pokemon games, well, spin-offs anyways, have been released on the, Wii U Virtual Console.
I'm talking, Omega Ruby.
Well, you would need a 3DS capture card for that.
How do I do a capture? Where do you get capture cards?
They are very, very hard to come by. for the most part.
One second. Google, you're my pal. Let's see if I can find a capture card.
You can find capture cards for normal for consoles, but not for handhelds.
There we go, capture card. Okay.
So I give you Super
I found a capture card, but it's $141.33. God damn.
What kind is it? You know, I would have considered buying the NES original. But
the shit's that.
But what the heck, I decided to get the GBA version for a change.
Oh, there you have a it's on a website called Kaiti, and it has a kit that allows you to capture from like the X and every quite a few, but I need to see how much it is.
Now the main thing about this game that confuses some people is the game considered canon.
$300. Need to find cheap ones. Right, so the cheapest one here is the is $249. Crap. I'm gonna be paying an arm and a leg just to get this software.
Now, if anyone's confusing as to why I'm starting off with this instead of Stadium 2, because it's a bit difficult for me to try and locate and set up the N64 at the moment. And Jake's in the chat. Welcome. And call 9518. Welcome.
In my stream. By the way, this Sunday, Saturday, I'm gonna be streaming with, I'm gonna have Phantom in the stream locally. I'm gonna be streaming Adventure Quest.
Okay.
Yeah, and yesterday he and I were doing a test run with one character I created. Mm-hmm. Oh my god. He gave for the first, like, mission you do, it's a kidnap mission. He was giving the guy in question a pedo voice.
Seriously?
He wasn't meaning to. So I was like going, Phantom, what the hell? You're making him sound like a creeper! He and I were just rolling, and...
One interesting thing about the GBA port. They actually included the e-reader features in the console releases. Yeah, Jake, I kind of wondered that myself. Why have the GBA version instead of the SNES version? Oh. Now this said, you can actually replay stages in this version, so let's give that a test. Work out how. Anyway, Jake, you want in on the call? Oops. I just have a soft spot for a Mario 3 soundtrack. Ow! Damn it.
Oh, sorry. So, D, depending on what time I stream on Saturday, would you like to join me in Phantom?
Depends of what I'm doing.
Okay. And hopefully, but yeah, he also cracked this one joke about one of the characters that you see from the prologue.
Damn it! Get back! Oh, shit, gone.
What ended up happening was my character ended up getting like killed, and I made the deal with the Lord of Death. Anyway, what ended up happening is I ended up getting killed. And the knight character I'm talking about was screaming, "I shall avenge you, my character." And Phantom put it better. But he said, no, sir, you are a disgrace to all knights everywhere. Turn in your axe, turn in your armor, turn in your cape, and go home.
Anyway, Jake, you ready?
Oh wait, is he gonna join our call?
Yeah.
Oh, cool. I haven't met him.
See if I can find him first.
He's nice, right?
Yeah, he's not that bad.
Anyway, okay.
Let's see if he's ready. One moment, guys.
Wow, that is a cool pony character.
Let's give him a bit while we wait. Let's go on to the cards. Oh! Two.
What's going on?
Where is ya? To be honest with you, I've got this game on the NES original on my 3DS that I've still yet to finish. Come on, Jake, where is ya? Next up, level 6. 1-6, actually. Oh! Anyway, anyone in the chat got any questions? Just to get some conversation going. Okay, let's pick a number between 1 and 18. Pick a number between 1 and 18.
Hmm?
Pick a number between 1 and 18.
16.
One mushroom. Now pick a number.
14.
Two mushrooms. Right. Another?
8.
One up. Another?
2.
Bob Fireflower. Anyway, another number.
6.
Again?
I said 6.
I know. Another number.
Oh. 10.
7, 8, 9, 10. Beep. 10 coins. Okay, Jake's ready.
Thanks. I got you some good stuff, didn't I?
Let's take on the Hammer Brother.
Hello.
Hey, yeah.
Hi.
How's it going? How's it going, man?
Not too bad. Still feeling stiff.
Apparently things... Yeah, I heard something went down with you. And who's your friend?
This is Kage.
I heard Ellie mentioned you by name in the stream a few times. Nice to meet you.
Yeah, it's nice to meet you too.
Anyways, the first castle of the game. Oh, it's terrible! Yes. The king has been transformed! Please find the magic wand so we can change him back.
I don't know, like, if I was turned into a giant snake, I mean, if I was kept the ability to talk, I probably wouldn't be complaining as much.
But then again, do you know the differences between the original NES version and the All-Stars version?
I assume that, like, in relation to the original and the All-Stars version, I imagine that the king's forms...
are different.
Yeah, the king's different forms are different. Some of them are sprites taken from previous games in the collection.
And some from Mario World, apparently.
Yep. Funny thing is, I mean, one of the worlds, the king was transformed into Donkey Kong Jr.
Well, of course. Then Yoshi.
Yeah, it was like, and it was the All-Stars version of Mario 3 I grew up with as a kid. It actually took me a couple of years to realize that, because like I've seen Mario 3 on only the 16-bit consoles that I had. I could not conceive that this was originally an 8-bit game.
Damn it, just a sec. Ow.
And I'll also say about Mario 3 that, like, in relation to the rest of the series, this one has the best gameplay simply by virtue of it having no elements
to
complement the experience.
Oh, splendid!
You know?
I am back to my old self again. Thank you so much. Here is a letter from the princess.
It's like you hear what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because, like, you know, other Mario games, like at least some of the modern ones, just stick us with one to two new power-ups, and that's pretty much the experience. At which the early Mario games never had that problem, I think the closest pure Mario experience that we've gotten in the modern age, which definitely explains a lot of people's liking for them, is the Galaxy series, which, you know. Even though that game has power-ups, because they're kind of downplayed, which is kind of frustrating, it does purify the experience somewhat.
Fair enough.
If that makes any lick of sense.
Right. Anyways, we are now into Desert Hill, or Desert Land.
Seriously, you would think being a snake... someone would actually be very content with.
Woo! Yeesh, that was close.
Yeah, true. With S's, they'll probably be like Cobra Commander.
Cobra!
Cobra!
Orochimaru from Naruto.
Oh god, yeah.
Right, we're probably going to do the first two worlds before moving on to the next game or so.
Mm-hmm. And you know what? Speaking of Orochimaru, it kind of blew my mind that Steve Bloom was actually the guy who voiced him. And I'm just like, well, Steve Bloom can do creepy.
Of course.
Yes, it can.
And it's pretty much it's funny because I think Orochimaru is pretty much like Heath Ledger's Joker, you know.
The only good snake is a solid one.
Metal Gear.
But then again,
Metal Gear. Aww.
By the way, have you seen that sketch on Twitter I did of GoldenFox as Solid Snake?
I think so. Hey, by the way, Jake, by any chance, are you a fan of Pokemon?
Why, yes, I am.
Yay, fellow Pokemon fan.
Yay. I was actually familiar with it back in Gen 1, but I couldn't actually play a game of my own until Gen 3 because my older brothers hogged them.
Right, anyways.
Yeah, my dad always got with me, my brother. Our dad always got us, like...
Anyway, guys, can I stop you for a sec? Mm-hmm. Pick a number between 1 and 18, excluding 16 and 14.
Well, hold on, before you do that, for a bit of a safe bet, just click the bottom corners. They're usually always stars. The two bottom corners. Because like, those are usually always stars.
God damn. Anyway. Pick a number between 1 to 18, minus 18, 16, 14, and 13.
See? And...
Six.
One star. Another number.
Yeah. One.
No, because the upper corners are usually like a flower and a mushroom, so... Mm. You know, if we're gonna go with one of the corner ones, then okay, never mind. That's a star, so I guess I'm in a loss here.
So pick a number.
Okay, how about 11?
11. Okay then.
If I get it right, it's gonna blow my mind.
One up. Well, wait a minute.
Darn it.
Cause I can remember that one.
And I think my favorite Pokemon games to date. Are the Gen 2 remakes.
I'm more or less a fan of Gen 5, honestly. Well, the second half of Gen 5.
I'm just saying, if we're talking about specific games, in terms of my favorite generation, I'll have to think about that. Because I'm still debating.
Well, I will admit, the Omega Ruby Alpha Sapphire is amazing.
They're the most complete Pokemon games to date in terms of features.
I know. I mean, a second story after you beat the main game, it's amazing. They haven't done that like the Heart Gold Silver games.
Yeah, it's just making me wonder what Sun and Moon are going to pull out.
I'm kind of hoping they bring back character customization and all that jazz. Because if you ask any of my friends, I love customizing my characters.
Look, we have a boom boom.
It is so much fun.
Brother, what a boom boom.
Kage, if you don't mind, I'm adding you as a contact.
I don't mind at all. I actually like having fellow friends who are MLP fans.
Yeah, that's good.
Seriously, I only like before I met,
right,
like...
so who do we have in the chat besides us?
Before what I met, like, you and, like, Evie and, like, Phantom and Ellie and everything, I only had,
did
like...
you just see a fire snake disappear through the floor?
I'm actually not even... What? Yes, it did.
A fire snake just disappeared through the floor.
Yes.
Okay, yes, then.
Code of limitations for its time.
Oh,
whoa!
Sorry, I forgot you were there. I didn't mean to. Didn't mean to kick you in the butt. I'm sorry.
What?
I accidentally kicked my doggy in the booty. And now I'm scratching and giving him kisses.
Yay.
I know, John. Yeah. I was just making sure who was here.
But yeah, it's before I met you and like DB, Jake, I only have like my brother and my and a friend of mine and to speak Pokemon about.
The poor bastard? Who's MLP? The poor bastard?
I only have three people to speak MLP about.
You know, that you know, more the more friends the merrier, I say.
Oh dear. Here comes the sun. Damn, I completely forgot about that. Holy shit, I'm trying to attack me? Jesus! Comes the it just burns! Get away from me! Oh! God damn it.
Okay,
Yes?
I have a question for you guys.
Yeah?
Oh. There we go. Mm-hmm. My question is, who is your favorite princess?
Oh, too hard to pick.
Flurryheart is in the mix, of course.
Well, it's kind of hard to call because each one has their own merits, and I'm just like, I don't want to sound like I'm picking the obvious choice. What about you? I mean, assuming that your Skype pick doesn't give it away.
I will admit I do like Princess Luna, but for me, it's actually a tie between everybody and their mother is probably gonna... Every freaking Luna fanboy is probably gonna castrate me with a rusted spoon for this. But my favorite princess is a tie between Princess Celestia and Princess Luna.
Well, that's a bit too obvious.
I will admit, though, I do like Princess Twilight, and,
But to be honest, I feel like I like Cadence a bit more.
Heck, I love and adore Flurryheart.
She's a baby.
Yeah, she's cute. Also, yes. Speaking of Flurryheart, I absolutely hate the fact that half the people were freaking hating on her.
And I'm just like, people, it's not gonna be freaking Fairly Odd Baby 2.0, well, right?
No, that's not why I was upset. It's like, it's freaking like Princess Twilight Sparkle all over again.
Exactly, and I'm just like...
Heck, when Cadence came on the scene, it's either half the people like it, or half the people wanted to freaking burn it with fire.
And I'm just like, God forbid that the show progressed to somewhere interesting.
Exactly.
It's like, you know, people can, like, you can have your debates, but honestly, in my personal opinion, at the end of the day, I'm just of the opinion, like, God forbid a show progresses to someplace interesting, you know, build something of a mythos, which most kids shows wouldn't even bother doing.
Exactly. And that's what I like about this show. It breaks the mold.
Yeah. But I will.
Gets created. You know?
Yeah, as
Lily stated on his video, those who use the excuse, but that wasn't Lauren Fouts' original idea, she put it the best. Lauren Faust wasn't fired. She left on her own free will.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
And honestly, I love what Megan McCarthy's done with the show.
Yeah.
Even though there are some writers that have questionable content.
You don't care.
And in terms of MLP writers, this may be a very simple choice, but and I know she's not around it and around the show anymore. But Meriwether Williams had the most duds under her belt.
Yeah.
I mean, like I said, I know I'm not making the most radical of calls, but that's just what I see. I mean, her only. I'm just gonna say this for the record. Wonderbolts Academy is hands down her best episode.
Don't we get Amy Keaton Rogers' best episode, which would be the main attraction?
Main attraction is still, like I said. If that episode hasn't, I know it's not exactly the most radical of choices, but that's still my favorite episode because it's just hit me in all the right ways.
But then again, I also do have a soft spot for Amending Fences.
Yeah, that's also a top tier episode of season 5. This is how I work, Kage. I have a tier system for each episode of a season.
Yes, I probably would too. For me, here's where I come from. For me, a low tier episode would be like putting your hoof down. The reason putting your hoof down for me is a low tier episode is due to it causing me pretty much triggering some emotional past memories I'd rather keep buried.
Yeah, I got you, but I think if I ever get around to ranking, that was season 2, right?
Okay. All right. Back to the card swapping. Pick a number between pick a number, either 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, 10, 12, 15, 17.
4.
1 fire flower.
All I can say is...
Oh, wait a minute, I know what it is.
There
we go.
Just click 4 and see what happens, because if it's a star, then immediately go to 6.
Right, so... Because
I know that corner is a star.
Right. Next number.
One.
Mushroom.
Oh, wait. Oh, it was a mushroom. Let's see the... 7?
20 coins.
Ah, darn it. Well, at least we have our corners mapped out now.
Right, anyways. Next number.
2.
2. Fire flower.
Let's see, 9?
9. Mushroom.
Darn it.
Where is the number where the mushroom is?
6.
Yes.
It's time to go into the pyramid.
Yes. Because, as we all know, the greatest evils do happen to come from ancient Egypt! For those of you who...
I was hoping you would make a Thundercats reference, but... Oh well.
Well, I mean, it was a joke from Linkara, if you watch his stuff.
Yeah, manga comment, I do watch his stuff.
I said Linkara, though. I wouldn't be imagine if manga took some inspiration from him.
He did.
Okay.
But during his commentary on the top 10 worst Pokemon design, he did.
He quoted the ancient Egypt joke?
Yeah. No, actually, because one of the choices this dude on his top 10 list, he put Kofagrigus, mispronounced the name number 1, freaking butchered it, and what he was saying was it was so bad, the Pokemon thing, it was just a coffin, a place you store dead bodies in with arms.
Am I the only one who seems to think that episode with the Yamask taking over Silent was a bit creepy?
Yep. But I mean, I haven't really seen. Like I said, I haven't really kept tabs on the anime for. It seems to be about a year and a half now.
Okay, I'll run into that.
Anyway, but yeah, I actually think Coffeegrigus was actually rather original.
Yeah, and I'm just kind of thinking, I think Coffeegrigus could use another evolution, sort of like a mummy Pokemon.
Exactly.
I have no idea. It's like they could totally do that, and I think they can. Let's see.
I wouldn't be surprised if they did. Anyways.
And obviously it could probably be a ghost ground type, you know.
Mhm.
Anyways, okay. Time to move on to castle number two.
Dang. Castle number two?
Yep.
Also, the original Toad sprite, isn't it funny that the original Toad sprite from the first game looks like he was flipping you off?
Really? I never really noticed that.
Yeah. Yeah. He's like,
just a sec.
He was giving you double the birds.
Be back in a sec, guys.
Okay. We'll try to entertain the people.
Come on, Jimmy.
But anyway, yeah, dude. For me, I personally like that they're expanding and adding more Alcorn. Because the more Alcorns there are, the more we can learn about their heritage and everything else.
Yeah, build the mythos, you know?
Exactly. And that's what really irks me. So when I saw about Flurryheart in the trailer for the show, I was just flipping tables and gushing and just so ecstatic.
Yeah, it's like, I'm just thinking like, this could open story possibilities, but people just gotta flip their shit. About this stuff, just like, people, there are worse things that this show could be doing, okay?
Exactly, they could be making freaking Marvelous Ne'er-Do-Well 2.0.
They could be reforming big bads like T-Rex, which for the record, they shouldn't be doing.
Yeah, I'm kind of hoping they don't try to reform, Chrysalis, I would like to know what made her.
Chris, we kind of got a bit of a motivation out of Chrysalis that. Her people. It's like I said, all I can say is, like, in terms of performing the big bad, performing villains, leave the big bads alone. Chrysalis, T-Rex, leave them be.
Exactly. They need to be left alone.
Yeah. Bring back Iron Will and Flim and Flam for that kind of thing, and we might have something, though. I mean, you know,
yeah,
I'd like to see
Flim and Flam, they could go screw themselves with something rusty and sharp.
I mean, because, I mean, like, there is, like, in my first, like, I mean, like, I think, like a Reformation episode with them, like, I mean, that can lead to something, like, that can lead to something interesting, because if you go back to Super Speedy Cider Squeezy 6000, they come up more as ambivalent, as more ambivalent con men, okay, well, not really con men, like, they were willing to deliver a quality product. The only real problem is their eagerness to cut corners just to meet a deadline, and, like, you know, that ambivalence can lend itself to proper character development. We're talking about Flim and Flam right now.
Despite some
character missteps in Leap of Faith, which I still go on record as saying is a good episode. Like, aside from those character missteps, I think there's still enough material to work with for possible Reformation episode.
Yeah, that's true.
I think what would be kind of interesting if only one of them reformed.
Do you know? I'll be honest with you. Do you know what one sort of con man sort of character I actually prefer, honestly?
Hmm?
Mr. Venkman from the real Ghostbusters.
Peter Venkman, yes.
No. His father, the guy.
Oh.
For one episode, he invents something called Venkman's Ghost Repellers.
Mm-hmm.
Aye, Morty. Or should I say, Big Mouth! If you've ever watched the Super Mario World cartoon.
But anyways, what I would like to see that I think would be kind of interesting if they do like a Flim and Flam sort of reform episode. Like, I think what would be interesting is if...
Yes? Oh god damn it, the thing's gone again. Give it a moment. And it dropped. Right, bear with me a moment, guys. Anyways, while we're sorting that, welcome to Waterland. Oceanside. Why must my internet always give me grief? In terms of Wi-Fi. I hate it when it does that. Did Kanke drop? I'll get you there. Or did she leave? Let's try it again.
Yeah.
While we're doing that. What was you saying before I got rudely cut off? Hello? Hello? Oh, I think that thing's acting up again. What did you say? I couldn't quite make out what you said.
Right now?
You're coming in rather crackly on my end. Damn it. Not very well. Give me a moment. Just need to sort the damn connection out. This is probably the weather outside. Can you hear me now? Oh, get off. Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
Right. What was you saying?
Before I was just asking if I could be heard over you, but you told me I was kind of crackling.
Anyway, right, we'll sort that out. What was you saying beforehand?
I think that was it.
You was in the middle of saying something as I cut out the first time.
Yeah, I'm trying to piece it together, but I'm also kind of waiting for Kage to get back.
Am I the only one who seems to prefer the underwater version, underwater theme from Mario 3 to Mario 1?
Yep. This one's better.
Flip the card again, right. Right in the corner was a top corner was a mushroom. Mm-hmm. Top left hand corner. So let's go with. That's that. Cool. What are you munching on?
Chips.
Oh. Oh. Why did I do that? Did Kage say where she was going?
No.
No. She probably had to go and deal with something.
Well, I'm gonna see if I'm just gonna like it says over there that she was unable to join the call as they need to update Skype or some.
Ugh,
for God's sake. I'm just gonna try adding her back in again. See
okay.
What happens.
We could try and see if Eleora wants to join us.
Sure.
Nice if she just. Oh, we got a frog suit.
Yay.
Let me devour you, you sick toons.
Yeah, she still drops, so I guess we gotta wait till she gets back online.
Right. Oh no, oh no, oh no, get away from me!
Oh, this asshole.
Hey, Mario, let me devour you with these sick toons.
I mean, like, as much of an asshole as this guy is, I'll gladly take him over that frickin' eel from 64.
Oh!
Did he eat you?
Yes.
How many people made Jaws jokes whenever this guy showed up?
Probably quite a few.
And I just saw that. Like, he just literally came out of no place. And just like that, you gotta fight a Hammer Brother in one of those waterlogged stages, which... not really easy. Okay, you have Star, never mind. You can own these clowns in like seconds.
What is the better version of the athletic theme for Mario 3? Now, this version? The NES version, or the one that was used in Galaxy and 3D Land?
I really wouldn't know. We'd need to really take time to compare them.
You can just click through me. Not that it matters, because I just roasted him. Try and keep the chat occupied with something.
So, chat, seen any good movies? I have returned. Cool.
Any luck?
With what?
Kage.
No, it says she's still away.
Let's see if I can get Joey in.
Try asking Ellie or...
Right, we're gonna take a short break for a moment. For a little snack break.
Am I making you hungry with my snackage?
No, basically, I just had to do a pizza because Dad was impatient.
Okay. This fortress got me stumped the first time I tried it. I think it stumped everyone.
Oh, fuck. God damn it, I missed again. Since we're water level, let's give the Frogster a try. And I immediately lose it. Anyone else still in the Twitch chat? Okay. New set. Pick a number between 1 and 18.
Well, as soon as the stream catches up. Well, do the bottom corner because those are always stars. We know where the mushrooms are now.
And again, it's not an alien. By the way, anyone familiar with the gaming historian? Because have any of you seen his video on the battle between Nintendo and Blockbuster? Can't voice chat anymore until later.
What?
Kage says she can't voice chat until later.
Any reason?
Probably something's come up. Japan. like an alien again. To nuke him? No! I'm not that sadistic. An interesting dessert. That's where the castle, is where Kyoto is.
Joey.
And I get another fox suit. Oh, good, it's this snibble. Who's in the call? Just me and Jake at the moment.
Kage was here, but stuff happened. Also, I am one of those people that's not really a huge fan of these auto scroller levels.
Nah, me neither. Be tempted to buy Mario Super Mario Advance 2 on this little bit.
Yeah.
And we could play that for a little while.
We'll see.
But in terms of quality, what is your opinion on the GBA version of Mario 3 All-Star port?
It's just a GBA port of a game you can get on the Super Nintendo. Just whatever.
Yes, it added things like features you can get from World and 2. Even some Mario 3-ized versions of Classic Super Mario Brother levels by the e-reader.
Didn't know they had those.
Well, they included them in the Virtual Console in this version. ran into Boom Boom again.
Yep.
I've yet to finish the NES version of Mario 3. I mean, I've got it on my 3DS, and as far as I've got is Iceland. Okay, I kind of just stood there. If there's one thing that bothers me about the All-Stars port is in the original, the Mario's gloves were the same colour as his face, which made it hard to tell if he was wearing gloves at all or not. Which is one thing they managed to fix in this version of the game. How's the stream quality for you?
It's doing good.
Right, just making sure. Hey!
What?
He swallowed me!
Freaking big fish. Not to be confused with the Tim Burton movie. Plus, okay, I've seen how the fish swallowed you in. That was your mistake for going the lower level.
Okay, just give me a moment. I didn't do the call.
Hello?
Heyo.
Hello.
What is up?
Not much.
I'm just playing some Mario.
I'm spreading the word.
Okay. What? Oh, damn it.
So, favorite Mario. Go.
The classic or the Super Mario Wii version?
Whichever.
Either one. Which one do you hold in high regard?
Super Mario Wii version.
New Mario Brothers Wii?
Yes.
Okay. I personally picked Mario World.
Same.
I don't know. I'm not as big in the Mario World.
I got you. Mario Brothers Wii.
I just went with my gut.
I got you. Mario Bros. Wii. I like the new
I've yet to actually try and finish Mario Wii. Though I played the new Super Luigi U.
I like a few of the new Mario Brothers games. The only one that I kind of don't like is New Mario Brothers 2 on 3DS. That just like, I mean, say what you will about the stagnancy of the Mario games, especially the 2D, the new 2D ones. Like, at least keep the same spirit as the original ones. New Mario Bros. 2 just kind of felt like a gift. New Mario Bros. 2 just felt like a gimmick to me from start to finish.
It's the only one I've actually managed to finish.
The whole coin collecting thing.
Yeah, but it was the only one I managed to managed to beat all the way through.
I managed to beat all four of them. One on the DS, the one on the Wii, and the one on the Wii U.
No.
You've got mail.
I tell you, I'm great. I'm a kind of a Mario freak, and I usually go out.
We kind of all are in some sense of the word.
Yeah, I've managed to. I always try to complete whatever Mario game I get my hands on, including Mario 3D World, which was kind of a bitch.
It's not that bad.
I mean, I'm just saying the completion curve with that game is really, really steep. Like, you have to beat every single level with every single character. And that's not counting the fact that you unlock Rosalina later on. So, yeah. Like, it's not bad, but like I said, it's a grind.
Also, sorry if you keep hearing a nose trombone. I think I'm coming down with seasonal cold.
I'm kind of surprised that I haven't come down with Concrud yet.
Consider yourself lucky in the meantime.
Yeah.
Now I'll be on the lookout for Concrud in a few months for Brody Cobb.
Yeah, I wonder if Toon's going through Concrud right now.
Probably.
If he's going to like to a million conventions, I wouldn't be surprised.
Well, actually, he's taking a small break for the time being.
And honestly, I don't even see myself going to another one for a while because I'm saving up for a new computer, and because I underestimated how much this trip actually costed me, I have to wait a while because had things gone down the way that I thought they would, I would probably be here planning on what computer I was going to get right now.
I won't bother with that.
So there's one con I want to try to go do besides that's another pony con. I want to see about going to a Power Rangers convention.
Oh really? That'll be interesting.
Yes. Because all of my friends most of them have met the Power Ranger, and I have not yet! That is sad. So I vow, with my nose full of goo, that I will meet a Power Ranger in person!
Not to go to Japan!
I said Power Ranger, not Sentai Warrior.
I know. I'm talking about the game.
Oh. Well, still that timing.
Right then. Level 3. After this, I think we'll swap to the next game.
Okay. I was just gonna say, I was kind of still waiting for Kage to get back.
Has anyone seen this video where this guy combines every single Mario 3 level into one video? And plays them all at the same time?
That's insane!
I'll probably show it to you later.
Also, have y'all seen the trailer for The Great Race?
Yes. I'm a little bit skeptical. But I'm interested to see how it will go.
Are you skeptical?
The premise.
I'm just interested to see how these international guys play out.
And the one that looks like a football player. The only one thing to say about that. What an asshole!
And Gilbert Gottfried.
Because he looks like a charging chuck.
What, the Canadian guy?
Hey, it's me. It's a me. Mario.
I'm just thinking if Gilbert Gottfried were to do a Jerry Lewis impression.
I know a lot of me with high amp shoes and swords and pantyhose on pre-lighting!
Yes, there it is.
Right. Anyway,
let it be known that Joey Turner is our Jerry Lewis Gilbert Gottfried love child.
Sorry if it's not my strongest. Like I said, still got a bit of sickness.
Yeah, you're fine.
Anyways, time to move on to the next game. And what should it be? I wonder.
It's the first Gilbert Gottfried. Sickness is an idiot. A dingleberry.
Let's see here.
But yeah, it was also cool to see Flying Scotsman.
With moving smoke deflectors for some reason.
Okay, I was actually about to ask, is that a real thing?
No!
It was. Are they turning him into a transformer?
Good luck, little brother. They probably made it look, make it like the sports visor. They probably wanted to make it because it emphasizes the speed voice, but, and the one thing that bothers me, why the hell do you need to give Gordon streamlining? It looks wrong. Anyways.
It's not going to last, I can tell.
Probably not. Anyway, what we're going to be playing next, considering what I played last week, who's up for some space shooting?
That depends on what that space shooting is.
You'll see.
Starfox.
Uh-huh.
Coolios.
Message from General
Starfox 64.
Priority one. Considering the fact is the new one is coming out in 2 weeks or so.
Yeah, about, let's see, I think it's April 22nd, I believe, and yeah, in about 2 weeks.
Let's Flippy Toad. Poopy Hair. Falco Lombardi. Fox McCloud. Oh, good grief! Look who's just appeared in the chat!
On who? Oh. Mr. Golden. Dare we ask if he wishes to join us?
If you like.
Yeah, if it is, it's his call.
Well, first I just want to know how he's doing.
Yeah, I was going to ask that. How are you doing, Goldie?
He's laughing in the chat, so I assume he's in a good mood. You'll think. Okay.
He's alright. No pressure, broski.
It's cool. Just enjoy the show.
Right. Right, then.
Okay. Also, I'm really looking forward to the new Star Fox.
As am I.
Really has promise. And this is, coming from somebody who genuinely liked Star Fox Assault.
I've yet to play Assault. I've got it, but I haven't had time to play it.
Here's my biggest problem with it is that, here's the thing. The story campaign in Assault is good. The only real problem is that, despite that, it feels like an extra
hold on a sec. Just a sec. He says, from what I'm hearing, there's a bit of a delay between the stream and the chat. Upon their arrival.
I think that happens to a lot of Twitch streams.
Yeah.
I have a lot of games. You could put it that way. I mean, I've got this on the original N64. I also have it on at the 3D re-release on the 3DS. And I recently bought this a few hours ago. Because originally I was going to stream Stadium 2, but couldn't have the time to set up a N64. So then, let's begin.
It's about time you showed up, Pop. You're the only hope for our world.
I'll do my best. Andros won't have his way with me. Open the wing.
Of course, we're going to have to forgive me for to get to grips with the controls again.
Check your G-diffuser system. Falco here. I'm fine. This is Happy. All systems go.
Flippy here. I'm okay.
I see him up ahead. Let's rock and roll.
Anyways, Golden said, Assault was underwhelming to me. Most of the levels involved getting out of your R-Wing. The first stage was presented very well. It was fast-paced, and I loved the updated FPS. But after that, it was out of your R-Wing and standing on the R-Wing, which was dumb. I can understand that the mission structure was a bit scatterbrained, to say the least, but at least, the storyline that was going on.
Oh, he says he's up for the call.
I'm ahead, man.
You want to let him in? Go right ahead.
Okay. I'll just wait.
Come forth that there was better man.
who doesn't love a good Christmas Carol quote?
Hey, Golden.
What's up?
Not much.
Hello, sir.
You guys paused the game just to... Yeah, never mind.
Was rolling out the red carpet for you.
Well, table is reserved, so...
You've got an enemy. Use the
brake. May I wipe your bottoms,
Joey, no.
Don't go that far.
We're not that far. We're not that five-star boy.
I'll take this one.
All right. I barely have any stars.
Whoops. Sorry. Didn't mean to do that. Because for one thing, I need to check them. Get the controls.
Anyways, like back to my thing on Starfox Assault. My only real problem with the game is just its heavy reliance on multiplayer, because you have to play a lot of that game to unlock all the multiplayer stuff, and I'm just like, okay, I get that it was originally a multiplayer-focused game first, but when you make the story when the story campaign is, despite being coming off like an afterthought, being like genuinely, like, I won't say impressive, but it was at least competent, it's like, the over-reliance on multiplayer just kind of because kind of feels odd.
Oh, nice. I'm just looking at the screen right now. There's a there's actually like a printed instruction manual on the screen.
Yep.
A lot of the virtual console games do that. Right. Anyways, I actually memorize what ones are which.
Okay, I can kind of see why the controls would be difficult using that thing. Because it's got, like, a similar control scheme of, like, a Super Nintendo, and the N64 has, you know, a set of four buttons for a C.
Okay, we'll just have to take the old route.
Do a barrel roll!
Granted, you get used to it after a while, but the first time you try it, it feels really awkward.
Yeah,
but you know, it just goes to show how well Starfox 64. It just goes to show that like Miyamoto made the right decision making this game for the N64. I mean, despite the fact that Star Fox 2 on the Super Nintendo was probably going to be awesome.
Oh, yeah.
I've heard some people play Star Fox 2 on the SNES and said it was pretty good. Some said that they liked it more than the original Star Fox, though I can't really debate that because I never played the game.
I did see it once.
Yeah. Because apparently...
I was a bit lost right there.
As I understand, like Nintendo was like just about finished with the game and ready to release until, you know, the pole was plugged. And also, ladies and gentlemen, one of the easiest first bosses in any game ever.
Well, in some way, it kind of has to be easy in order for like the newcomers to like progress in the game.
Yeah, I know, but I'm just saying like. For first boss thing, all you gotta do is just shoot the guy's leg and then you just pile on the lasers.
He's like, I'm going to crush you. Oh shit, off the leg. He's like, yes. Oh fuck, I never planned this ahead, did I?
Nope, you did not.
I immediately wanna quote that very old Family Guy episode with y'all.
You would have to say this as I still have a stiff knee.
And he's just doing that as he's being fired on.
It's not even that, his freaking leg gets blown off. It's like, fuck. You know, like the guy in the pilot is like, doo 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 doo. I didn't plan this out very well, did I?
We did not plan ahead.
Nope.
This kind of makes my... me feel about having a stiff knee a bit less awkward, does it? If you're not exactly sure what I mean by that, Goldie, I had a bit of an accident last Sunday. Because basically I stepped in a burger box, slipped, and damaged my right knee.
Ooh, ouch.
That is never a fun time.
We're now entering the asteroid field.
Yes.
Like, one of the asteroids, hits them. It hits whatever that thing is called, I forgot what it was.
The Great Fox.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and it just, breaks apart. Like, at first I thought it was gonna, bounce off or something.
I'm definitely hoping for Star Fox Zero. What this game captured that no other Star Fox game did was, first off, we already know that Miyamoto takes most of his inspiration for this series for Thunderbirds, which, if I can recall, was a kind of a campy show, and I think this game...
Campy?
Kind of get...
I wouldn't call it that campy.
I don't know, this game's, its dialogues that are endlessly quotable have a bit of a campy feel to it. The later games haven't really captured that, and I don't think they ever will again.
Here comes a big one.
It's funny though, when you enter through that long corridor, or that huge cavern, it creates this echo effect. Technically, there's not supposed to be any sound in space.
Well, of course.
But fuck logic.
It's a video game.
What logic ever done for me?
It's space. No one can hear you shoot.
Location confirmed.
Space. No one can hear you take the crane. Yeah, okay, I don't really know what that was. I just felt like saying something.
I wasn't saying anything. The cockpit view. The cockpit view is a little too difficult for me to work with.
It's better than the SNES original.
I didn't mind the cockpit view in the SNES game. God. So much nostalgia. Okay, so when we first had the N64, the game that we first had was Mario 64, me and my brother, and afterwards we had Star Fox, and we played it so much more than Mario 64.
Yeah. If those were the first two games I ever got when I got the N64.
Hmm.
Yeah, I think Star Fox 64 was the third or fourth one we ever got, because it started off with Mario 64, then Mario Kart, and then this.
Mario Kart.
Yes. Still, the debate continues which one is the best one.
I still like Mario Kart 64 more.
64 and Double Dash. Either one.
I tried Double Dash, and while I appreciate its ambition on doing something different, I still enjoyed Mario Kart 64 a bit more. To be fair, though, it is, they tried to do something different. If it tried to do the same thing like Mario Kart 64 did, there wouldn't have been any innovation. And that's something that Nintendo was mostly known for these days.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah.
Yep. And here's the thing, in terms of that debate, I think Mario Kart 8 would have been up there if it weren't for the baffling choices that they made with the battle mode.
I haven't played the later installments afterwards. I have a Nintendo Wii, but I haven't tried the Mario Kart on that one, nor do I have a Wii U.
Well, I was gonna say, Mario Kart Wii, it's alright, but I don't know, something about it just kind of felt meh to me.
And this is why I don't like the cockpit view. When you're actually in the cockpit view, you're spinning like crazy and you can't see shit.
Yep. And in terms of Mario Kart 8, everything checks out except for whatever the heck they did with the battle mode. Because basically what they did was, they gave us the battle mode. They gave us the usual battle mode thing with the balloons. Except the catch is we're using the entirety of the race of certain racetracks. And I'm just like, okay, why? Because that just makes battle mode all kinds of cluttersome. Because, like, you know, the simple squared off arenas in past Mario Kart battle modes were genius. Why they did that, I'll never know.
Yeah. The battle mode in Mario Kart 8 really bothers me. I
admit. Exactly. It's like, you had one job, Nintendo. The one time we're sticking to formula would have paid off. But then again, you know, whatever. One hiccup in an otherwise good game.
Well, can they be doing any worse than Konami?
Yeah, well, Konami's been digging their own grave. Konami's probably all filled up their grave by now.
Probably.
It's gonna be a deep grave.
They have thrown Castlevania, Silent Hill, and Metal Gear under the bus for the better part of last year.
Both Konami and Capcom have been screwed over so bad that even saying their names, it's... I've taken a few hits,
but I'm okay. Also, might as well throw Ubisoft in that pile too.
Yep.
I mean, look, Ubisoft, whatever you're doing with your Rayman game, keep doing that. The rest, stop. Assassin's Creed series or whatever. I'll probably try out Black Flag and maybe Syndicate, but that's about it. And the only reason I'm interested in Syndicate is because I like the Victorian steampunk setting.
And Johnny Hedge Wall Street says no one could do worse than Konami.
because fuck Konami. Speaking of Mega Man, I heard through the grapevine that they recently released Mega Man Legends 2 on PSN.
Not here, though.
Didn't Mega Man Legends receive a bad reputation?
Probably to diehard Mega Man purists, maybe, but I'm willing to give those games a go. They have Legends 1, Adventures of Tron Gone, and now Legends 2. So, yeah. Like to see Mega Man, and you know, something that I'll probably get to one day, but I have to be careful with my money for the time being.
You're dead meat, pal. You're not getting away that easy.
Pew pew pew. Yeah. Legends sucks. I tried to stream Mittens. I couldn't even finish the first stage. I think I've seen the recent episode of Angry Video Game Nerd, and the dialogue boxes easily get in the way of the gameplay.
Yeah, and X5,
man. Okay, as far as the X series go, I loved X's 1 through 4. X5 just ruined it for me. And it's not just because of the dialogue box. The stage designs were like, eh. The boss battles were fucking cheap. Like, there was one boss where you fight him on top of some kind of plane, and he has this trick, he'll fly up and push you off the platform. Which is so cheap.
I think that's Skyver you're thinking of.
I don't remember the boss names, they were that forgettable.
Funny thing though, most of the bosses in that game are named after Guns N' Roses members.
Yeah, that was talked about. Also, the fight between X and Zero was underwhelming. Granted, the music was awesome, but all he did was, like, he jumped, like, up and down, shooting in different patterns and such. If you played X2, Zero was just fucking, ferocious towards you. I mean, you had to have a lot of skill.
It was also a lot darker.
Yeah.
As far as X5 is concerned for me, it is a mixed bag, but in my personal opinion, I really liked the ending because, you know, it felt like a reasonable conclusion. X6 can
feel for me. Sorry. No, like, the ending for X5, it was reasonable until they decided to milk it out with X6. X6, I couldn't even play through. Like, I couldn't even finish a certain stage. I'm like, fuck this game.
Like, here's the thing, I actually managed to finish X6, and like I said before, X6 can fucking blow me.
Yeah.
It's like, it is to date the second worst game that I've ever played, and I know that's kind of a tall order, but, you know, I play games rather selectively. It's very rare where I can actually say a game sucks. A game that I seek out actively sucks, and the only other game worse than that I can think of is Devil May Cry 2. Like, that game is just a whole load of garbage.
Come on, where is ya?
Now let's move on to a more positive subject than Mega Man. Which is your favorite, folks?
Of what?
Mega Man X1 for me. It's okay, it's like a tie between X1 or X4. Those ones I enjoy the most so far. I did try out Mega Man 2, and it's a lot of fun. I still have yet to beat it.
Let's see. Kind of going through my only real frame of reference for the Mega Man series as of now is mostly just the Classic and X series. But kind of going through them in order, I like X2. I like Mega Man 2, 3, 6, 7.
There we go.
9.
Mega Man 7. I've heard a lot about that one. That one has, like, some kind of currency feature where you can, like, purchase, ammunition or extra lives.
Yeah.
Well, don't be fooled. The currency system, at least as far as I've experienced, actually works pretty well, but I think that's because I've actually set aside time to grind, and it's not really as easy as you think if you know where to go.
Yeah.
I think 7 is my personal favorite because, I mean, it just feels, it felt like the most logical conclusion. And as like I said,
then there was Mega Man 8 on the PlayStation.
I'm not a huge fan of 8. I'm just throwing that out there.
if you want a definitive version of Mega Man 8 to play, I would recommend you play the Sega Saturn version.
Second what?
The Sega Saturn version of Mega Man 8.
Ah.
Like I said, I'm not even a huge fan of. I'm not even a fan of Mega Man 8 as a whole. Just for the people that complain about the currency system at 7, they do a worse job with it with an 8.
Because of the corny voice acting that was also used for X4.
Well, look, I could at least laugh at the corny voice acting, and just some of the gameplay just kind of felt off. And like I said, with the currency system, they don't just drop bolts all willy-nilly. You gotta collect them throughout the level, and you don't even get to unlock all of the upgrades once you do get all the bolts, which is like, what the fuck? It's like the currency system in 8 is broken, pure and simple.
And they also limited the amount of big bolts you can find.
That's what I'm saying. Let's see, like I said, 2, 3. I'm probably in the minority of people that regards 6 as one of the best, as one of the better games in the series. It's like 2, 3, 6, 7, 9, and I'm just also gonna throw this. I'm sorry.
No, go ahead.
And I was just gonna also throw this out there. I actually really liked Mega Man 10.
Oh, as do I.
Wait, another there's game. A 10?
Yeah.
Yeah, there's Mega Man. Yeah, there's a Mega Man 10.
There's Mega Man 8, there's Mega Man 9 and 10 released for the, PSN, Xbox Live Arcade, and WiiWare.
For Wii, yes. I really liked Mega Man 10, and it's in the same boat as 6 in terms of games in a series that get a bad rap. Undeservedly. And in terms of the X series, I like 1, 2, and 4.
1, 2, and 4. Well, that kind of makes sense.
Yes, 3 was a bit three was a bit too cluttersome for me, but nothing I can get too worked up over. 5 was half and half, and 6 was absolute garbage.
Yep. No, like, my brother and I agreed, like, X6 was, like, to him, he thought it was worse than X7.
And I still have to play X7, because I took it upon myself to decide to play every single entry in whatever Mega Man series I'm playing, and I am not about to fork over more than $20 for a copy of X7. I absolutely refuse to. Mega Man 8, maybe. Mega Man X8, maybe, but not 7.
The thing about 7, they were, they, like, the graphics were obviously 3D, and they were trying to create a transition from 2D platforming to 3D gaming, which is fine. They wanted to make it, you know, more of a subtle step instead of a dramatic step.
They wanted to be a bit of ambitious with it.
Yeah, but the screw up was is that it's just like, it's weird working with the controls and the jumping feature. Like, I think they could have worked with the mechanics a little bit more. You don't have like a full free range control of where to direct your character, kind of like in Super Mario and The Legend of Zelda, where the controls in any direction are much more freeform. It's much more stiff, kind of like Mega Man Legends. And for having the jumping feature, the wall jumping feature, I would have preferred that it would just like have the game like automatically target your character into like creating like a wall jumping, so that way he could focus like wall jumping towards whatever it is that he's climbing to.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I just felt like it could have been tweaked much better.
Mm-hmm. And also,
I appreciate its ambition, but it's just
it just did not pay off. And also,
the whole Axel thing. Like, I know that there's that saying, "Don't judge a book by its cover," but
Axel's a pretty rough cover to judge.
Yeah.
And also to Johnny Hedgewolf stream, like, I wish I could avoid X7, but I've played all the entries in the Classic series up to that point, as much as I thought Mega Man's 4 and 5 were kind of underwhelming.
What about X8?
And eight is bordering on garbage. Like, I don't totally hate it, but it's not one of my favorites.
Then again, there's also the oddball of the series, Super Adventure Rockman.
what I'd really like to play either by emulation or if I could actually track down like one of those bootleg cartridges is Wily Wars on the Genesis.
Oh, so do I.
I've heard about that one.
Like, it was only released on the Sega Channel in the States, and I'm just like, why? I mean, you made a Castlevania and a Contra game on the Genesis. Don't see why a Mega Man game wouldn't fit.
I think I could just like, I haven't played the game. I'm just guessing that maybe that Capcom wanted to try something for the Genesis in regards to their mascots.
I think it was because, as the gaming historian put it, it was something to do because they wanted to cement a partnership between Sega and Capcom. And they decided to make the Wily Wars a Sega Channel exclusive in the US. While over here, it became physical release.
I'm probably in the super minority. I've never played a Mega Man game.
I'd recommend Mega Man 2 or Mega Man X. That's a start.
What system are they on?
Mega Man 2 is on the NES and Mega Man X is on the SNES.
Yep.
Then again, there's also Mega Man 3.
Also on the NES.
Yeah.
All I need to do is get an NES.
Which, nowadays, are a little bit pricey online. Though not as pricey as certain games. Like, I've looked on Amazon and eBay, and the prices are just ridiculous.
Yeah, retro game collecting is kind of a hot commodity right now.
It's a bit of a mixed bag. Like, if, let's say, you want to get Street Fighter, you can find it online for, like, $20. But if you're looking for Mega Man 7, I shit you not, they're over $100.
That is highway robbery.
Yeah. Same thing with X2 and X3. Like, X3 is $200. Fuck that.
Yeah.
Which version? The SNES version or the PS1 version?
Yeah, I've heard about that one. I did hear a sample of their music. That's all I can say there.
Yeah.
A Sonic and Mega Man crossover.
They kind of did that. They kind of did that.
They already did that with the comics. But in terms of video games, I don't know how well that would translate.
Because Sonic games are like a racing platforming sort of genre, whereas Mega Man is just jumping and shooting.
Jump and shoot!
Yeah, to quote from Egoraptor. Hey, what you doing? I'm nothing. I'm just jumping and shooting. What are you going to do next? Oh, no, I'm just going to go here and jump and shoot!
Jump and shoot!
The tumbling blocks. It's funny how, like, they're just rolling, and then they decided to start hopping.
I really like this boss. Like, he actually becomes a looming threat within this level, and I like him.
He's also just Trey. Present there.
Also, trains. Insert your own Thomas the Tank Engine jokes here.
Someone would have to bring that.
I'm just picturing, like, this guy, the way he talks. For some reason, I imagine this is what would happen if Sir Topham had turned evil. Became a maniacal train-themed supervillain. I don't know.
I know less than you, man.
Let's see.
Now, that part was a pain in the ass. Trying to hover your tank.
It's more difficult when you're not exactly sure which one's the Z button on this.
Let's see, other games I'm looking forward to in the future. Well, yeah, there's in May there's Uncharted 4 and the new Doom. I think there was a third one, but I can't remember. Also, hold on. Didn't they say Mighty No. 9 was possibly going to come out in May? You're very lucky. I think if they delay it one more time, I'm going to give up on it. Anybody got a video game series that they'd like to make some kind of return?
There we go. Best ending to a boss ever.
Do remakes count?
Sure, whatever.
Yeah, because somebody on Tumblr asked me a question about what game I would like to see redone. Call me crazy, but I'd like to see Demon's Crest redone.
Yes, that
underrated,
needs to happen.
A beautiful game.
Exactly. Yes. Capcom. I don't care what grave you're under. I don't care what kind of niche you think that would fill. Make that shit. Make it now.
Since it's me.
Oh, it sucks for this guy.
Yeah. That's all on the Dragonagefan is Kage, right?
No. Yeah.
Hit the brakes.
I love the ending to that boss.
Yeah, that's funny.
You know, yeah, it's just like boom, boom, boom. My brother and laughed at it so much because of how over the top it was.
Yeah, and Peppy was the only one with you. Frog with you?
Yeah, he was.
Oh yeah, he is. Oh. There he is.
Bring back Devil May Cry.
Yeah, like. Do a continuation from 4. Also, if that's Kage, if you want to come into the call, you're most welcome to.
Kage?
Okay. I think that's her in the chat. I think that's her in the chat.
Dragon.
It's like if you want to join, feel free to do so.
Just give me that.
Is the username Luna the Wolf 6?
Will do, General. There's still nothing.
May try and venture a guess which game you want to see a remake of.
I'm still trying to.
I'm still trying to figure out what game I'd like to see. Area 6. Except... Oh, okay, yeah, it's her. Yeah, Kage, if you wanna, like I said, if you wanna join in, feel free to do so. You just gotta give us the yes or no.
Media
37
Max, hit the road.
I just want to add something to Starfox 64. Like, okay, it's got a really good gameplay. I also love the soundtrack on this one.
Yeah, I think this song from this level probably the best of the whole game.
Yeah, because it's very intense, and it's like it's adding a lot of build up towards the final two stages. Because after this, he had to confront the Star Wolf again, and. Was it?
Andross?
Then you confront with,
Andross.
Andross. God, my memory's so vague on this game.
This part was
so annoying.
What?
The landmines. Space mines.
Oh yeah, those things. Let's see, if you're asking who's with us, Kage, it's me, Joey, and GoldenFox.
And D-Birch. You can't forget the host, man!
I know, it's just that Kage was specifically asking DB. I was just making things easier. Because it's obvious that DB is here, he's the one hosting. I figured that went without saying. Anyway, hold on, what was... Something that I'd kind of like to see, but I doubt will ever exist. Like, with the existence of DuckTales remastered, I'd kind of like Capcom to do a remaster of Aladdin on the Super Nintendo.
Yeah, that would be interesting.
Yeah.
I know that in the there was like a competition between Capcom's version, and there was also one made by Virgin on the Sega Genesis. And personally, I like Capcom's more. But the people behind that game, they actually admitted that they like the Genesis game more. I don't know if it's a guarantee if they would make it happen, but I'd like to see how they would redo their version.
I remember that old Magical Quest Story Mickey Mouse.
That too. I mean, there was a remake of that other Mickey Mouse.
Castle of Illusion.
Yeah, Castle of Illusion.
A funny thing about that game, because I remember Zach streamed it a while back. Like he started streaming that game like a few short days after I myself 100%ed it. So like I already knew what that game was gonna be like.
Also, to answer your question, Dragonagefan98, I have not played Dragon Age.
Me neither.
Yeah. For Sonic 3 being remastered, weren't those games that, kind of remade for the DS? Or am I mixing that up with something?
I don't know if they were, but... I think you're probably thinking of the Sonic Advance series on the GBA, I think, I don't know.
No, I've seen gameplay of Sonic 3, and they were using the same sound and music, with just 3D graphics. Maybe it was fan-made, I don't know.
Speaking of which, I'm kind of surprised that aside from that new Sonic Boom game on 3DS, we haven't really seen another console-based Sonic game in a while. And that's when Sonic Boom came out, and literally blew.
The problem with Sega and the Sonic franchise is that
they milk it too much.
I give them the benefit of the doubt that they're willing to try something new and are going to be ambitious, but they are rushing through their work way too much. I mean, they repeated the same mistake with
06?
With Sonic Boom when you think about what their other game was, Sonic 06?
Yeah.
Yep.
They rush it through just so that they can get a release on the holidays. Guys, take your time. Take another year to make your game if you have to.
And it also makes Sega look pretty damn scatterbrained. Like they have all these ideas, but they're not willing to expand on them. Makes them feel scatterbrained. It just makes makes Sega feel very scatterbrained.
Oh, this boss was a pain in the ass. Almost half the time, I always lost my wing towards this guy because he would whip out one of its lashes and I'd lose a wing.
Yeah.
But getting back to Sega.
Yeah.
The funny thing about that is that when you think about the character of Sonic, most of the time I just think of him as a symbol of the idea behind working with the speeding of your game. Because, okay, when the Sega Genesis came out, they wanted to define blast processing, which means that even though it's a marketing term, it also refers to the how fast their functionality is compared to the Super Nintendo. So they made, like, Sonic, presumably, to show how fast the game is able to keep up with the character. But as a result, this is just them getting their work done fast. And you know that scene, speed kills?
Yep.
Oh,
this is the mistake that Sega keeps repeating. I don't know. That's just the way I see it.
I'm a firing my laser.
And you know, the failure of Boom is kind of tragic because, and I'm just gonna toss this out there. I'm actually one of the few people that actually genuinely liked Sonic Lost World. And I'm just like, you know, there was a foundation you could have built from that, but no.
That's that.
Yippee! You did it! Good on you, Kage. Good on you.
How much are you willing to bet that caused a lot of seizures on kids from that beam?
Probably not as much as Electric Soldier Porygon.
Motherfucker! Wolverines! Oh, there we go. Fuck you. God, that guy is such a pain in the dick.
Yeah.
Not as much as these guys, though.
I think the toss-up for worst boss in this game is a toss-up between that thing, just for how extensive his attack is, and the giant clam from the water level.
I didn't have that big of an issue with the water level. It does get overwhelming with all the projectiles coming at you.
It just took too long.
Yeah. What other boss was a pain in the ass? Oh, that Saturn planet. There was some weird creature that popped out from the ground and was holding Slippy.
That thing looked creepy as hell.
It did look creepy, and it didn't freak me out. I just thought of that thing as a pain in the ass.
Hmm.
You know, we're going to, like, our way to just save Slippy because of how much of an idiot he was.
Yeah, going up, trying to take on that robot boss from Sector X head on. And then that robot was all bitch please. It actually slaps Slippy's ship down to that planet.
I'll take care of you.
It's like, it's next up. No.
It's like, fuck that shit.
Oh, yes. Facing Star Wolf in this stage was a pain in the ass, because they always find a way to get behind you.
Oh!
Like,
was stupid.
Yeah, assault. Like, not assault, but somersault, U-turn. You have to do that more often than, you know, actually hitting them. And you have to be mindful of your other buddies because they're all like, Fox, get this guy off me! He's like, oh my god.
It drives you mad!
You're always counting on him. He's already going through... he's already going through so much shit as it is, guys. You can do the same thing. You can pull off a freaking U-turn. You can pull off a somersault.
You know what? Like, in relation to this specific battle, because I'm sure because Falco is not with you, DB's being tailed by both Wolf and Leon right now.
I feel so sorry for you.
He's got two Star Wolf flunkies on his wing right now.
No, I mean, he just lost a life. Now he's got that single shot. The single shot is so hard to work with.
Yeah.
You have to be so precise.
Yeah, that's... Yep. Get to the pond, froggy.
I'll take care of you.
This is really funny to kick me off! I was never really bothered by Slippy. Like, whatever, you had to save him, but you know, there are worse things than being a damsel in distress, you know?
Yeah.
That's saying.
Because you're the one being counted on. Oh!
And like, God!
I'm just looking at the game, they're like, Fox, get this guy off! He's like, fuck you, I've got two guys behind my back.
Got him, yeah.
You get them off your back.
So, DB, don't forget to do a bear wall.
Easier said than done!
God, Pepe is pretty much just like a meme, like General Akbar.
Okay, well, guess what? Star Wolf just cleaned out the rest of your team. Now you got all four of them on your ass.
Oh, God damn it! God.
Well, you killed Pigma, though, so. Now you only have three of them on your ass now. Yes, Leon, we get it. You'll take care of me. You'll take care of him. I get it.
I'll take care of you.
This is the third time he's. It's like this is the third time he's.
But I'm better.
I saw Leon read that line. It's like this is the third time he said it. And now.
I love what Dragonagefan98 says. And the memes begin.
Yes, all the memes.
I think we shall take a moment of silence to honor the memory of Admiral Akbar.
It's a trap.
It was a trap indeed. Thank you. Thank you for teaching us better with a trap. Okay, who wants lunch?
Well, that was fun. Who's for Chinese?
You
make sure you never be Jandros.
Fox, you're talking to the wrong person.
Ah!
Shoot it! Thank you! I talked to who I want to talk to.
I feel really out of practice right now.
Yeah, well, Star Wolf in this part of the game has always been tough.
He's always a pain in the ass.
Especially considering that, like I said, Falco's dead, so you have Wolf and Leon on your ass.
At least you can say you have practice on this game.
Wow, did I just take out one of them already?
Not yet. The party's just begun.
Nope. I think it just grazed one of them.
I'll take care of you.
Yeah.
I'll do you fast, happy old pal.
Usually when my aunt gets up is when I have to start doing the whole ball and everything.
Okay.
Priorities.
Yeah, I'm home. I'm home.
Okay.
Yeah, kind of. This is happy fun time, and let's just say there's another depressing story. Yeah, I'll say it in the chat.
Okay.
Don't say it out loud.
I got you.
Alright.
Okay, go.
We'll just see about that, Star Wolf. Is that all you got?
Okay, now what?
Get this guy off me!
Take care of the guy behind us!
I'm looking for the
button!
Why the scene on those asteroids made me think of Ratchet and Clank with, let's kick some asteroids!
Don't get too cocky, Starfox!
This is getting really annoying!
I feel your pain, dude. It's like, fighting with just that single laser just makes it a hell of a lot harder.
It can at least give you power-ups when you get multiple lasers, right?
The only thing you get are bombs.
Right, because multiple lasers would make sense.
Bombs?
How do you feel about ba-bombs? Ba-bomb!
I think I tried doing it before, homing the bombs on the enemies, or these ones. They're probably too evasive. And there goes Slippy. Oh, God.
My mom, on the other hand, yeah, that's another, that is some, I actually am on not speaking terms with her.
We'll make sure you never regain drugs.
Yeah.
We'll just see about that, Star Wolf.
So I'm curious, what are your guys' opinion on the Fallout series?
I have never played the Fallout series.
Dude, you're missing out. It is amazing, especially Fallout 4. Fallout 4, by far, has been the best Fallout game of the entire series.
I am a dying for every time.
He was so close to reaching that ring that would repel his health, or replenish his damage system.
Ouch.
I had a dime for every time someone told me I was missing out, I'd have a hell of a lot of dimes!
Fallout 4 seems like a game, but the Fallout series, at least relating to the ones that I actually can play right now, which are 3 and 4, seem like games that are a bit out of my league, you know? Something that I should play at some point, but I'm a bit intimidated by.
Dude, trust me, it's a lot of fun. It has a widespread world for you to explore. The graphics are beautiful. The storyline's actually quite interesting. And you can choose if you want to be an a-hole or the very sovereign who saves everybody from the brink of destruction.
There's two problems I have for playing a game. One, I don't have the proper system for it. Like, granted, it's on Steam. But I need, like, a good working computer in order to get it. I'm still in the process of saving up to get one. Two, I haven't been very fond of modern games that involve a lot of exploring.
Yeah. Like, if you're not into that, then Fallout 4 and Dragon Age probably wouldn't be the game for you, especially Inquisition.
They're the same people who made Mass Effect, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that probably made you, because Yeah, BioWare, because I played the first Mass Effect, and I was confused as hell on what you're supposed to do.
Actually, I think Dragon Age is the more, like, easy-to-understand version of Mass Effect, to a certain degree. Though, it's pretty much the game that, it's pretty much like Mass Effect that the choices you make affect the game and everything and whatnot.
Uh-huh.
Like, if you say are a complete a-hole, your teammates will freaking give you the finger and ditch your ass.
Let's see how you and that's not cheap.
Yo, being an a-hole ain't fun if it results in everybody wanting to freaking put an axe in your head.
And not that I know personally, but having an axe in your head is not cheap.
Unless you unless you like the feeling of getting a splitting headache.
Yo,
oh my god.
No, like, when it came to Mass Effect, there were so many different kinds of races that you had to spend a lot of time learning. And part of the reason is because, like, I didn't realize this until afterwards, that the certain characters of certain species of what
they
are...
I didn't know, having my own problems to deal with Epi?
For instance, I was on this, like, what is it, like some kind of frozen cold planet, and when finally confronted with the boss, it was a pain in the ass until my brother jumped in and said, did you equip Rex with a shotgun or no? No, was I supposed to do that? Yes. How was I supposed to figure that out?
Yeah, you're looking at the girl who is the huge...
And we just shot down Andrew!
Dude. Oh dear.
You were saying...
Yeah, as I was saying, you're looking at, I'm like the hugest freaking Dragon Age, Mass Effect, and Fallout fangirl you will meet. I like pretty much know everything about the games. I know all like the hidden secrets and whatnot. It's...
But I'm better.
That's cool.
Yeah, I really do find it very enjoyable, and hey, I find it as a good stress reliever. Take up your TikTok, go try to destroy the collectors or the reboots or the gas. That's carnage. Always the best way to relieve your anger.
Or just play some kind of a shooting game.
Exactly.
Yeah. Oh, I do have this one story. I was playing Legend of Zelda: Link to the Past, and at one point I was lost.
Oh, mind gosh.
You, this was on the this was like the emulator that I was playing before I got the cartridge from David here. I was in the Dark World, and I was like having trouble finding a way to enter the seventh dungeon, because there's seven dungeons total. And I'm just like, there's that one piece that I have to get. It's one of those power medallions. That you have to access. They call it the Quake.
Okay.
Normally, I have the impression that whenever it comes to collecting these things, you find a tombstone that has, like, an encryption on it, and you've got the Book of Murdia, and you have to, like, read it off of it, and that's where you get the medallions from. So I'm like, where can I find one of those? This whole time, the Keyframe was watching me play the game, and she's like, hey, babe, go to that one stage where you know that circle of rocks?
Yeah.
Throw something in there. I was like, yeah, I threw a bomb in there and nothing happened. Babe, throw a rock, don't be lazy. So I threw the rock in there, and then in comes the Time Monster, and then in comes the Quake Medallion, and I'm like, what, what the fuck? I was flipped by shit so much. I was constantly like pressing my sword, like swinging it, like so I saved the game, I turned it off, and I put on Contra just to let out some stress.
Oh god,
You play Contra to de-stress.
I definitely have a similar story to a stress story as well. Whenever I beat a Pokemon game, I always try to do legendary Pokemon hunting. Pretty much try my best to get every legendary in that game. Well, I finally met all the requirements to get all the Regi Trio. I already had Regirock off crossed off the list, and he only took like 8 Ultra Balls to catch. So I had 48 Pokeballs on me. So I went over to go get ready ice. I swear to God, there's never, now, mind you, here's a little known fact about me. There's never been a time, a Pokemon, I ever wanted to put a swear word in their name. Not for just the giggles of it or anything, I never wanted to do that. Regice was the first Pokemon that we made me want to put a swear word into their name. Let me tell you why. Now, I thought, okay, took 8 Ultra Balls to catch Regirock, so I thought, well, it probably wouldn't take long to catch.
For God's sake, will you get off my freaking back?
I feel so sorry for you, Birch.
I just realized Andrew's the one chasing you. I have to say, do you have a monkey on your back?
Let me fuck off.
Oh my God.
Thank you, and good night.
Anywho.
Take a boost and get out of here.
Anywho.
Yes.
8 minutes later, after I started my trying to catch Regice, it literally, 48 of my Pokeball, Ultra Balls, gone. Just gone. Didn't work. I had to turn off my 3DDS because I have the special edition, limited edition 20th anniversary 3DDS.
I think I might need a bit more practice before going back to this for a while.
Anyway, what ended up happening, what ended up happening was I did not touch Pokemon Omega Ruby for the next, like, almost for the rest of the week, due to it making me mad so much, to the point that I actually wanted to turn my DS into nothing more than a circuitry explosion against the wall. Yeah, so pretty much, once I finally caught Regice after attempt number 2, I actually was screaming, hell yeah, take that, you icy motherfucker, and I was even putting up both middle fingers at the screen.
Okay, one second,
and
guys.
Then, if it wasn't for the fact that I had in mind a name scheme pattern that I wanted to do with my, with the Regis, including Regigigas, I would have nicknamed Regice Icy Bitch. That's how much it pissed me off. I wanted to name it Icy Bitch because now I absolutely cannot think of Regice without getting this look of absolute disdain on my face. I hate Regice now because of this.
I feel you.
I love it.
You know what I mean? It's like all the other Regis, including Regigigas, the one who's supposed to be like the king of all three of the Regi trio, I was able to catch with no problem. Regice, on the other hand, was a little eptard.
he gave you the cold shoulder.
Oh my God, you're now dealing with Phantom, dude. You're making the puns.
Nice one. Anyways.
What if I make another Regie trio? What about something like Regie Magma? Or Fire?
Regie Fire.
They probably might, who knows, but it wouldn't, technically it wouldn't be a trio anymore. It'd be like a quartet or something, like along that line.
It already is a quartet.
They got friggin' Regigigas.
Actually, Regigigas, they don't bunch up into the mix.
And what is the point of him? Or her?
Regigigas isn't it, and Regigigas is supposed to be the leader of the Regi trio.
Doesn't that make it a
Regi Quartet? I guess it's true. I don't know why they call it a trio. Pokemon's weird.
Someone is not using their logic brain.
Exactly, but Joey, think about this. It's Pokemon. Little monsters that can poison you, freaking set you on fire, freeze you to death, freaking blast you and kill you with dark voodoo crap, and also mentally blast you off into space.
And mind you, all those things you're keeping in your pocket.
Yep.
Destructive pocket monsters.
Yep.
Seriously, but it doesn't mean they get to confuse a trio for a quartet.
True. Also, here's something I always thought. Why the... Where... I'm surprised that... In every Pokemon game, you're technically the hero. And you're a 10-year-old. Where's the hell is an adult when you need it? Like, all adults seem to be incompetent. The champion, for Christ's sakes. The champion of the Pokemon League is apparently incompetent.
Not all of them.
It's like, Pouch? Dude? I'm only a 10-year-old kid. Why are you having me go face the terrorist organization? That can quite possibly and literally kill me by me walking through the front door.
Because all the cool kids fight terrorist organizations. Did right?
Yes.
Yeah, it's like... If I had a better art hand with humans, I can do Pokemon. I can draw Pokemon just fine. I try to draw people, and they become disfigured messes.
Right. Anyways,
seriously, I would probably do a hand-drawn parody comic of my character, like, going, okay, wait. Look, I'm a 10-year-old kid. All I wanted to do was travel around the region and freaking fight all the gym leaders so I can fight your happy ass. Why the hell are you having me go into a place that is full of lava where I could quite possibly get burnt to a crisp and die and fight a giant legendary Pokemon that can quite possibly wipe me off the face of the earth just by stomping on me? Yeah, seriously. Think about it. And for Omega Ruby or Alpha Sapphire, a perfect example. The world was somewhat flooding and or becoming a magma wasteland. And a 10-year-old was the only savior. Also, the fact they sent a 10-year-old into space to face off the Oxus. It's like Pokemon, where child safety goes out the damn door.
Not in this case.
Yeah, Pokemon Stadium is the good safety version of Pokemon.
Yep.
Hey, Jirachi! Yay!
I remember that Jirachi. Like, I gotta get one before the event is over.
Yeah, you have until the 24th.
I gotcha, because, you know, there are some legendary Pokemon that I've been meaning to get. And they're apparently pulling out one legendary from February to the end of the year. I missed the Mew event in February, one of my friends was able to hook me up with a Mew code. And, you know, Celebi was March, and I already had a few of them. Jirachi is now, and I'm gonna get me that, and, you know, so on and so forth.
Yeah, I already have Mew, Celebi, and Jirachi. I actually have a mini army of legendary Pokemon, believe it or not.
Or I think we've got rats in the
water. By the way, Jake, did you manage to play Pokken at Winnie City?
Sadly, no. I sadly didn't get to see Zach as often as I would have liked.
That's a bit of a shame.
Yeah, from Zach, I heard some not great things about Winnie City.
What's he saying?
That one of the staff members was really rude to him. I don't know, just go playing by what I heard.
Well, this is one-up live stream I'm probably going to upload later.
You, Kilo. Still, I don't know about y'all, but if your staff is going to be rude to people, that kind of means never going back again.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, I mean, if staff being rude to people, I'm sorry, but if that happened, I'm never going back. I'm going to say, okay, thank you, congratulations, asshole. You just left a customer, now I hope you go screw yourself.
And if you were a restaurant, I'd give you a 1-star rating on Yelp, because apparently that's what everyone cares about.
Exactly. Yeah, I mean, I'm sorry. You're looking at the girl who dealt with garbage in real life, and I sure as heck ain't gonna put up with it from some random asshole. Hey, look! It's David's favorite Pokemon.
Yep. The grass lizard.
Yeah, I seriously still need to draw you that Sceptile and Sceptile's Mega Evolution for you.
Did I already say what my team of choices?
Yeah.
Well, not just you, to anyone else.
Ooh, dude, you're getting nice, dude. But you're starting to get wrecked there.
Get wrecked.
About to get wrecked even more with this.
I just realized we're just doing pretty memes over and over again.
All the memes.
Exactly.
Hypercombo finish!
Yeah.
This is a grass type versus a ghost fire type. Where's the logic? Again,
it's a fighting game. Logic is thrown right out the frickin' window.
Oh yeah, just like it is in Mortal Kombat.
Right? Time where you can rip a guy's spine out of his body.
Yeah.
Yes.
Logic is something that does not exist.
Pikachu Library versus Weavile. Anyway, we're probably going to do a few random battles and then continue on with the Ferrum League.
Nice. Oh, dude, I like how you made your character in this game look like your icon. That's cool.
It's the closest I can get.
Yeah, it still looks pretty cool. Is this, like, the newest one that came out?
Yeah.
Oh, I can tell, because there's Pikachu in the freaking wrestler outfit from Omega Ruby. Let's see how much time we have.
I will be right back. I need to go check the mail.
Okay.
Yes.
Also, I'm curious. Has this ever happened to you guys? Have you ever gotten copyrighted for just the name of your character?
No.
I've heard of just as many dumb reasons someone would want to copyright something.
Well, you're looking at a poor girl who has people. There's a reason I actually stopped.
Like, suplex for the win!
I don't post my artwork of, like, my OCs and whatnot. I mean, they're not good pieces, but they're art pieces nonetheless. My OC, due to this incident. But because I actually had somebody once, I had a game on my, sadly my old BFN account got hacked and so and all that. Yeah. And I made this level on this game called Little Big Planet 2 of my OC, of a costume I made myself of my OC, Luna Akashia. I had, like, mind you, I created Luna Akashia like three years before My Little Pony Friendship is Magic came about. I got the whole, I had a lot of angry MLP, some angry handful of angry MLP fanboys saying, "Oh, you stole the name of Princess Luna, blah blah blah. I'm gonna, I bet you're gonna get caught if you took this to YouTube. You'll get copyrighted."
I guess that's mature.
Yeah, I mean, how is it copyright if you use a name? Like, that's like saying if someone else who has my name, say, has my first name, and if that would be the equivalent of me suing them for copyright. Yeah. You know, which isn't stupid, or is more perfect example, the Fine Rights Bros trying to sue people for what YouTube react videos. You know, it's like, are you serious right now? Like, I think I can find a picture of her. Give me a minute. I have a picture of her that a friend of mine drew. He's really good with anime sketches. I'd have to, and, you know, he drew me this beautiful picture of my OC, Luna.
You know, I kind of wonder, was Garchomp's design based on a hammerhead shark?
Garchomp. Yeah, I think I see that. Well, Garchomp's supposed to be a land shark. And not in the dumb B movie. Not in the dumb sci-fi B movie sort of way.
Welcome back, GoldenFox.
Yeah!
Thank you.
You're welcome. Hello. I'm waiting for my mother's tablet to boot up because I have it saved on here.
You guys are coming in quite quiet.
Are you playing a different game, or...?
Yeah.
Oh.
The screen is frozen on my end.
Uh-oh.
Hmm.
Might have to refresh the page.
Okay. One moment, I'm gonna show you guys the photo I'm talking about.
Okay.
Here it is. See the character right here? That's my OC, Luna Akashia. Okay, wrong photo. Yeah. See? Now, does that look like anything like Princess Luna from My Little Pony Friendship is Magic?
Nope.
Nope.
Yeah, exactly. And a handful of MLP fanboys were screaming at me, saying, "Oh, that's copyright, you're gonna get sued," and all this bull, and oh my god, what was that?
Yeah, what was that?
And what was my what? Brother, that was probably either my cat knocking crud over, or my brother accidentally tripping over the baby gate again. Yeah, to keep the dogs out of the kitchen, we have this baby gate in front of the kitchen door.
Right, I think that should be enough. But on to the main attraction. The Ferret League.
So, yeah, it's pretty much they're saying I'm gonna get sued for copyright if I dare to do what I really want to do, which is make an original series involving my OC, Luna Akashia, but of course I get the whole, "Oh, that's gonna be copyright," and all that bull, and it's like, okay, you know what, screw you, and, you know, it's like... So kind of stick to like telling this my ideas and whatnot to friends and what and everything else. It's like if some people are gonna be a-holes, then you know what? I'm just gonna share my ideas amongst my friends. But I am planning though to finally come out of my shell again and try to do what I wanted to do. I created an MLP my own MLP YouTube channel and everything, so I'm trying, you know, to do my own thing on that.
Cool.
Yeah, I'm starting slowly, though. I'm starting with, like, live streams on my Twitch and everything. And then, once I feel comfortable enough, I'm going to start, like, doing song covers and stuff like that, because I really enjoy doing music.
Mm. Cool.
Nice.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Oh, fighting games. Even Pokemon fighting games throw the logic of Pokemon out the door.
Yep.
Charizard should be owning Sceptile. No
yep.
offense, DG.
Yep.
Speaking of which, Charizard has a special place in my heart.
Everyone goes silent.
Yeah.
Right, who's next? Kristen with Suicune.
I return.
Yay.
Who's our grass is getting greener? Because again. I probably should not be out in the rain while I'm in the near stages of a cold.
No, probably not.
No, dude, that's no bueno. No, you shouldn't be. Yeah, Jake, if you want to know how old I am, that's totally cool.
Okay.
If you must know, though, I'm 18.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Why, but bursts in this game really seem to break it.
I'm okay with this. mostly because I like
And I'm okay with it too. Subtitles okay, but I prefer Suicune.
Whatever floats your boat. Dude, we've been in the same spot 3 times. Give us something different.
Give us a challenge.
Oh, hey, and there's my brother's favorite fighting type Pokemon. Yeah, my brother is freaking out with Lucario.
Something's up with the Something seems to be up with the sound.
What do you mean?
Can we still be heard?
Well, you can. I can hear you, but someone's going.
Whoever's dying, raise your hand.
I think someone's having connection problems.
Oh dear. Yeah,
they're gonna need it.
Is Golden still here?
Yeah.
Okay, just checking.
Weird noise. Oh well.
Someone's being called to another call.
Sorry,
Guys, we have a friend who would actually get amused by that. They do not like Weevil.
Mr. Grant, Mr. Arcade!
I don't know.
Oh, wait, it could be me clicking with my mouse pad.
Let's do a test. Quick, click something.
Okay. I click something.
Could be it, I don't know.
If it is, I'm really sorry.
I don't worry about it.
Just curious what it was. I thought it was Sanctions of Insanity. Finally, break it down. Maybe. Let's fuck. Get fired.
Good thing is, I need literally using my built-in microphone to it, my laptop.
Yay,
I'm not the only one. Also, it is out.
You alright?
Yep, because I bashed my finger between my brother's tablet by trying to catch it from falling onto my dog's head and in between my laptop. Yeah. Ow. Nothing. Also, it is raining like freaking heck outside.
Hello, clash of my favorites, Sceptile versus Charizard.
If I did still have to select a, if I had to select my favorite, like, grass type starter, Sceptile would definitely be on the, would definitely be the number one.
Sire.
Yeah, no offense to Bulbasaur and Sneasel and all the other grass-type starters, but I've always found Sceptile's design much more appealing to the eye.
He's one of the fastest.
Yeah, that's got
slightly nerfed to Gen 4, but I don't think that made much of any difference.
Certainly, I will admit he would be number two. Good job.
Pushed up to 49.
And of course, they kept Yaz's smug grin.
As he's just that smug. Like, yeah, I know I'm awesome.
The Festival of the King of Card, Magikarp. Ooh! Ugh, that is really
Magikarp, cool. Get your card, cub.
And I'm scratching your butt. Oops.
What?
The magic.
Magic.
I'm talking to my dog. She's laying like right beside me. And I thought I was scratching her head. Turns out I was scratching her ass. I will admit, Magikarp is pretty cool, especially mostly due to his evolution. Also, do you guys have any pets that are, like, very grumpy when you try to move them to get up for whatever you have to do, whether it be school or some, like, family activity?
Maybe one of my cats. Maybe the cats, but that's about it.
Yeah, Tilly will freaking growl and freaking throw a hissy fit. If you try to move her. If I was to move her right now, you want me to show you what I mean? Let me just, I'm gonna put the laptop near her. I want you to hear what she does. Just, this is what she does whenever you try to move her. Come here, baby. Do you hear this? Come on. one with his crabby butt. He growls. You get little Miss Crabby Butt growling. Your little crabby butt.
I'm getting slightly sloppy.
Come here. You are a little crabby butt.
Ooh, that was a close one.
And I will not tail the magic carp because aren't they kind of a pain in the ass to train?
Tell me about
don't
it.
Get me started on that. I remember when I first got Magikarp and I was trying to get it up to Gyarados, I was banging my head against the wall. It's like he has such a shallow move cooler. By the way, I'm gonna turn my camera on real quick because I have a certain somebody. I asked Jake if you wanted to see. Okay, honey. This is Tilly. This is my little Tilly.
Aww.
Oh, he's a cute little puppy.
He is a cute little puppy.
He's actually a rescue dog, believe it or not.
Really?
Puppy,
yeah. Yeah, poor baby has abandonment issues because her original owners abandoned the poor girl. Yeah, and they also, the people who rescued her, believe she was also abused. She's a very, very spoiled baby girl.
Yes.
Yes, you are. Like, yesterday I gave her the special, like, pork rib that my brother made with rice. As a treat. She's a very spoiled little puppy. Okay, you can leave that down now. Yeah, nothing wrong with spoiling your pets.
Nope.
Yeah, but Tilly's not my only pet. I also have two other dogs, a pug and a Chinese crested. And a cat. A cat that likes to give hugs.
Try to go out a million times a day.
Yeah, I know. I was actually chatting with you once when you had to let one of them in. Ooh.
Three cats and eight dogs.
Jesus.
Damn, my dad would never in a million years. I mean, I used to also have two pet turtles. One of them sadly passed away and due to some issues, we had to give the other one up.
Okay. My family really loves dogs, what can I tell you?
Aw, snap.
Dogs are certainly good companions. Cats are more popular in my family, because my Aunt Rose...
Pause a moment.
Aunt Rose has a cat. My grandmother has a cat. We have a cat. Mom used to have a cat.
Cats.
Yeah, so, yeah. I mean, cats and dogs are pets that are most common in our family.
I would imagine.
He's doing the insane laughter bit. I'm
going to
really.
Pause the scene for a minute. Just putting some gel in the knee. That's better. I'm having my ass handed to me.
Yeah, I see that. Ouch.
Unless I can pull back from this one.
I'm
And
you
I do.
Can, dude. You're pretty
just.
Also, by the way, Jake, did you do your icon?
No, I had Sapphire Hudson go on.
Oh, cool.
It was worth every penny.
Yeah, it certainly was. It's amazing. I really like the design. Is that supposed to be your pony OC?
Yeah.
Looks pretty cool.
Yeah. Oh, well, I'm gonna see if I can get vectors of him so I can get reviews going.
That's cool, dude.
Open into the bone out again.
Yeah. Gonna see where it takes me.
I didn't make a comeback.
Yeah.
Way to make a comeback, David.
Thanks.
No problem. Boom. There goes Gardevoir. Ooh. Sorry to hear that, Johnny. Yeah. That's rather dark. You two are a great
team. I think my uncle accidentally, like, when I was like a kid, I think one of my uncles accidentally ran over one of our cats once.
Oh my god.
Yeah, it was not pretty.
Yeah, my mom once called me and scared the ever-loving crap out of me, telling me our dog, baby got hit by a car.
Yeah.
She was okay, yeah, though.
One of my labs got hit by a car. Thankfully, she survived.
Yeah, it's always good when they survive.
Yeah. Happy stream topic, talking about, well, you know.
It's starting to get a little bit morbid.
Yeah, can we not get morbid, please? Jesus Christ.
Let's see. Joey, do your happy dance.
Oh my god. Johnny the Hedge Wolf stream, dude. Good god.
What happened?
He just said at least he didn't die without pain. It's like, okay, yes, morbid. This is gonna be more morbid than freaking Fallout.
Okay,
and trust me, you can literally blow a person's head into itsy bitsy meaty chunks on that game.
I'm going to stop throwing happy tacos in people's faces until we get their act together. You think I want to do it?
I want to do it.
Now for a Skeptile upon Skeptile battle.
Wait, how do you know which is which?
Hey, by the way, curious question to you guys. Have you ever heard of the game's Adventure Quest World?
No.
Negatory.
It's a pretty fun game. Ooh, Sceptile with a Sceptile. Uh-oh.
Now what?
There's a Shadow Sceptile.
And Goldie's disappeared.
Maybe he just poofs to another dimension.
Probably.
Or he probably joined in another call.
Mm. That makes more sense than another dimension.
That or he could have been dropped from a call, who knows.
Either way, we'll keep his feet warm if anyone comes up to the smoking coil.
Yeah. Hey, Joey, is it okay if I add you on Skype?
Sure.
Okay, cool. I just wanted to ask before I even sent you one.
I'm not, but just so you know, I'm not Joey's chatty 24/7.
Hey, it's totally cool, dude. Dang, who's Skype getting blown up with messages?
It's me! It's because I use an internal mic.
Who's Zero Nero? Oh, Zero Nero, Aeon Kage.
I think that's Aeon.
Aeon? Who's Aeon?
Hi, Peter.
Yep. Hey, Aeon. You know what? Why don't we see if he wants in?
Sure.
Oh my God.
Hey, Aeon, you want in?
What the fuck?
Are you now?
Jeez.
Just know the storm you're about to unleash, and you will have to prepare your aim at first.
Oh God.
They even said so.
Ah, god damn!
Jeez, this child's kicking your ass.
It's been a little while, sure.
You know, your moves.
He says he's down for a bit.
Okay, sure. Just give me a moment.
I like your icon, Joey.
D-Birch made it.
Nice.
Come on,
huh?
Don't quit. Good work. Your battles are fun. You can just watch it.
The only person I think who's seen it, a picture of my OC I drew myself, is,
and he just... And it got... Wouldn't then connect. He needs to do an errand first, so we'll wait till then.
When you can't find the chat, group chat that you were in, that you sent the photo of your OC, I sent to a different friend. Oops. Jake and Joey, this is my OC.
Cool. Wait.
You're a changeling bat thing?
Actually, a dragon pony hybrid.
Hmm, cool.
Thank you.
Look, my friend Isaac. Next time you see Isaac, give him a try giving him a commission if he wants to see art stuff.
I might.
I'm commissioning him for a tile card from an ex fan pick reading. A reading of the classic tale that no one's read yet. I call it You Cut Me Up, Steven. The crossing of the Cinemax and TV.
Yeah.
I don't know, Uncle Grandpa, dude, if I can die.
No, you're fine.
Don't you think someone else on the bed?
Hey, guys, I'm gonna go, okay?
Okay.
I'll keep my homework started.
Okay, fair enough. See you around.
Bye.
Bye.
Yep.
Well, I probably might call it a night fairly soon. Because it is coming up to 20 past 9.
Okay.
Okie
dokie. So, we'll probably get to the end of this set and then call it. I'll probably upload the stream afterward.
I remember when I first took up on CPN at the end diamond. My Lapras kicked her Garchomp's ass.
Was she your key to victory?
Pretty much. I did not realize that. God damn it, Saber! God damn it, Doctor!
Doctor? Because if I just sit down for too long, they're just going to put pressure on the knee. You know, who actually likes going out into a city at night?
It depends on what one wants to do.
Brave, crazy people?
I don't know. Go for a night out, you know.
Mm.
See the sights. Go to a casino. That sort of thing.
I wouldn't mind going out for a bit.
I mean, it's been at least a couple of years since I last went out with a group of friends. More so old college friends. Because I did go to a few, college reunion parties in some places. At some point. Some years ago. Maybe I should ask when we should do it. When I should do it. When we should get them to do it next one.
I don't know how I was off of it, but I should mostly be careful with my car's sibling.
For luck. If Aeon comes back and asks what happens, just say it wasn't against him, it was just because I've been streaming for quite a while and my knee was starting to get uncomfortable.
I got you.
Okay.
Take care of your knee. Take care of your knee for a while.
Okay.
I'm just going to put a message down, just ahead of time.
And I think we're going to call it for night.
Okay.
As soon as, I finish up this bit. So anyways, thank you all for joining me for tonight's random game night. Special thanks to Jake, Joey, Kage and GoldenFox for joining us. So until next time, I will see you on either Monday or Tuesday.
Until then, live long and propane.